more interesting things I'm seeing a lot of lately is the intersection of art journaling and office supplies. We recently debuted watercolor journal deck cards, which are compatible with rotary file systems, and in today's video, I'm working with our brand new watercolor index cards. They're available in three sizes, plus tab dividers for each, so you can sort and organize them. Best of all is this tiered storage box that I altered with Art by Marlene collage papers. This index card box measures 7¾ wide, it's 9¾ inches from front to back, and then if you look at the side, it's 2 inches tall here, but then it inclines up and it ends up at 3 inches tall, so this is obviously progressively taller as you get to the back. I chose to use Art by Marlene paper on the side. I've got one done. I'm going to show you this other one in a second. I'm pretty certain that I'm going to leave the front and the back plain. I haven't completely made up my mind about yet that, but I think that that's where I'm going to go. Now, having said that, you can do anything you want. This is a wooden box. So if you want to block out some of the brown color, put some gesso on there. Want to get in there with some texture, use texture paste. I'm going to show you an interesting use for that in 1 second. Modeling paste. All of those kinds of mixed media things that we enjoy doing, layers of things with stencils, various kinds of elements that stick up off the sides or off of the edges here, whatever it is that you want to do, the sky really is the limit. The only thing that I would suggest when you are, so there's four dividers in here which give you 5 sections, and the dividers are removable. So if you've got a bunch of things that you want to put together, then just take a divider out and don't bother with it. When you're painting or adding thick media to this, keep away from the notches as much as possible. I know you'll want to paint in there if you're going to paint, but I want you to know that if you put glop too much in there, you're going to have some trouble getting these back in and out. Now, you could sand these ends if you had to shorten a little bit. Nothing is impossible. With a little bit of ingenuity, you can pretty much do whatever you want. So coming back to the sides, I used score tape on mine. I don't like the wrinkling that you get with wet glue, and you can see that this is on here. It's nice and tight. It's nice and smooth. The edges aren't lifting because I was really careful, and we'll talk about applying score tape in a few minutes, but I was really careful how I applied the score tape to make certain that everything was covered. Now, you'll notice that there's some white on here. Like anything made from wood, you're liable to see little defects. In my case, since I'm putting paper on here, I want this to be as smooth as possible, so I used texture paste. I could have used spackling, but I have texture paste on my workbench, so there's no point in running to the garage and finding some spackle. It works really well for this. So it's nice and soft, and when I applied it, I did it with a palette knife. Now I'm going to put a little tiny bit right here. It's not effectively going to do anything because that little area is so narrow. I'm not worried about filling it. It's not like the paper's going to get depressed in there. But all you have to do is just kind of smooth it on there. I'm going to get rid of that. And then you can come in with your palette knife and scrape off the excess. Now I'm going to pretend that that's dry, even though that it's not. Let me just put the cover back on the texture paste so it doesn't dry out. Once this truly is dry, so I have 220 grit sandpaper. I'm going to fold it in half and then fold it in half again. I work with a quarter of a sheet that I then fold into quarters. I find that that's what works for me. So again, ignoring the fact that I just put some texture paste on here, and in fact, I'm going to pretty much rub it all off. All I'm going to do now is come in and lightly sand this. And I don't care if I'm scuffing up the wood because, again, I'm going to cover it. If you're just painting, you can see how easy this is. This is completely smooth now. If all you're doing is painting or you're going to add texture, then a little divot like this or even this little section right here doesn't make a darn bit of difference. Then you can pretty much do whatever you want. So with this all sanded, now this side is ready to put score tape on, and I'm going to come back and I'm going to show you that in just a moment. As I filmed this in late October 2018, there are 2 collage paper packs in the Art by Marlene line. There's this one labeled 01, you can see that here, and this one labeled 02. So the paper I'm using is this sheet, and it comes from this 02 paper pack. Now, when I covered the first side, I used this segment here, and technically there's more than enough left on that sheet for me to be able to use what's left, but I've decided instead that I want to kind of repeat this on the opposite side. So this is score tape. It's what I've used on the side of the box, and I put the score tape on the box and get it all pressed in place, and then I get the backing paper lifted so I can take it off easily. I'm still sticking with the I'm only going to do 2 sides. I don't think I'm going to do the front and the back side. So here's the thing that you need to know. when you work with score tape, you should take your time and just cover everything really well. You'll notice as you look at this, so this is, you can't see it, but that sticky, that's because there's score tape there. Every single bit of this side is covered with it. I want to make certain that there's no pockets underneath where I might have missed, and I also want to make certain by running the score tape all to the edges that I'm not going to get any lifting when the time comes. It's all simply going to stay in place. So the way that this works is you remove the backing paper and then you adhere it to whatever you want to stick it to. To make this easy, I'm going to, let me orient myself here, so this is going to go on the wide side. I'm going to lay the paper on my surface, and then I'm going to remove the backing paper and put this on. That's going to make it much simpler than turning this up on edge and maneuvering the paper. It's just, it's way easier this way. So I've already lifted these, but when you do this, you'll find that tweezers can be very helpful. So this is already done to make this process a little bit quicker and easier. And as I said, you can see that there is, well, now, of course, I'm showing you, and I can't see what I'm doing. You'll notice that there is score tape everywhere. All right, so again, I want to, score tape is a one and done deal. You get one shot to do it right. Now, because this is not a mirror image, I'm going to end up with, let's see how I want to turn this. I'm going to turn this like this. So it's not going to be, because it's not a mirror image, it's not going to be the exact way that this is, but it's going to be pretty close, and they're on opposite sides. You're not going to be able to tell the difference. So I'm going to pull this toward me, and I'm going to eyeball this. I know I want this pretty close to the edge, up in this top corner. Now what I'm not going to do, and I'm going to peek up and over, get my hair out of the way. Well, end of story. It's done. It's down. You get one shot with score tape, which is fine. I can still make that work. It's going to be just fine. So as I smooth it on here, this is now firmly in place, and I can feel that there's no gaps and there's no bubbles underneath. So the next thing to do is to find the cutting pad, which I took out a moment ago. I need to trim all this off, and the best way to do that is with one of these self-healing mats and an X-Acto knife. So all I'm going to do, I'm going to turn this so that you can see it. Now this is not big enough. I have a big mat off to the side that I ordinarily work with, but all I'm going to do is grab, this is a funky kind of X-Acto knife. I'm going to use the edge of the wood. Let's turn this. I'm going to use the edge of the wood to guide the X-Acto knife blade. And all I'm going to do, a sharp blade is important, because if it's not sharp, you're liable to tear the paper. So I'm just going to press. This is not thick paper, so I don't have to have the death grip here and press super, super deep. Now the side of my box is longer than this self-healing cutting mat, but that's okay. So that's all I'm going to do to go ahead and trim that. And you know what? It's do as I say, not as I do. I'm going to bring this over. So this is a little bit raggedy, but it's not right on the edge. I'm going to take this over to my other cutting mat. It's going to be a little bit easier for me to do it. But that's the process. I'll go around and I'll do this around all four sides. And then from there, my box is for all intents and purposes done, because I am not going to cover this front or the back panel back here. I like the look that I get with this. It's bright, it's bold, it's beautiful, but it doesn't overwhelm the box. So with the box for all intents and purposes done, it's time to think about what's going on inside, and that's where our 5x7 index cards come in and the 5x7 tabbed dividers. If I could put my hand on one, so here's one. As you can see, they fit in here perfectly. So here's the box with both sides finished. The one thing that I did not say earlier, if you look at the edge, you can see that the paper is white. That's pretty much normal for most papers. If you want to remove that, come through with your favorite ink, whatever it might be, whether it's Distress or Distress Oxide, Wendy's blendable inks, some other kind, whatever it is that you want to use, you can do that, and you can just touch up those edges so that they don't show white. And if you want to add a little bit of darkness around the edge of the paper, you can do that too. All right, so there's the box completely done. We have three different sizes of watercolor tags, and each has a corresponding set of tabbed dividers. Having said that, I cannot put my hands on the 5x7s. So this is a 3x5 version. You can see that here are 3x5 cards, 3x5 tabs. We have one in each of the three positions, and the same thing here for the 4x6. 4x6 cards, and then tabs in each of the three positions. So here are the 5x7 cards, and let me just pull this box in for one second. As you can see, and I showed you this earlier, They fit in here beautifully. The dividers work. They kind of hold them in place. If you want to use the tabs to designate months or weeks or things like that, you can do that too. This is the same 140-pound watercolor paper that all of our watercolor products are made from, whether it's the art parts, the disc-bound journals, the tags, this is all the same stuff. So this is a card that I've got a background on, and this is the technique I'm going to show you, where I put these, I do this kind of finger painting thing on, help if I turned it right side up, where I do this on dictionary paper. And then the other thing that I'm going to do, these are Tim Holtz's Snarky. Small talk stickers, and I think they're hysterical, and I especially like the way they look, kind of positioned on those circles. But as you can see, this is paint, this is more ink pads, this has been sprayed, so this stuff is simply sturdy enough to hold up to whatever you throw at it. And before I forget, Stickles, because I threw some on there because I couldn't, I'm going to show you how to get this black around there too that you can smudge. So here is a piece of dictionary paper. I'm going to use three colors of dilutions paint, and I'm only going to put a little tiny bit out because I'm only going to do this once or twice, so I don't need a ton. She said, shaking the line to the tip of the bottle. There we go. I'm going to grab a little bit of, this is Peacock, and then I have Blackberry. Right, and then a little bit of Blackberry. So finger painting, I love to do this, it's fun. Sometimes it's nice to do things that don't require lots of deep thinking, lots of preparation or planning. You just go ahead and go for it. So again, I do this with my finger. I let the colors mix. Now, I like the finger marks that I get in there and the swirls. The thing to bear in mind is that if you mix purple and green and you really mix, you're going to get brown, because that's the way it goes. They're on opposite sides of the color wheel. But if you just kind of swoop this in there and don't allow a lot of mixing to happen, then you can play around with things like that. So honestly, that's all there is to it. You can see I've got some other stuff here. It's pretty darn straightforward. You can make them in whatever size you're moved to, big, little. Sometimes I leave the centers open. Sometimes I'll come back and kind of fill them in. Honestly, that's it. It is not rocket science. So let me wipe this up. Slide this out of the way and bring in this other sheet. I did these yesterday, so they're all dry, and you can see you can very effectively combine those colors that are complementary. They're across one another from the color wheel. You can effectively combine those as long as you just kind of swoop the color in there and don't mush it around and really blend it in. So the black smudgy circles. This is a charcoal pencil. All you do is kind of go around the perimeter. Again, this is not rocket science. Don't worry if it's perfect. And then I have paint on my finger. Then you come in and you smudge. If you want it really dark, then press really hard and put plenty of the charcoal down, and then you can smudge the living heck out of it, and you can get a much deeper aura or halo of dark around that, and you'll still see the marks, which I kind of like too. And then, of course, then the last thing would be Stickles. So for me, it's just fun. All I would do would be, I kind of draw with the tip, so I'm just going to do circles like that and call it done. And let me hold this up so that you can see it. And really, that's all there is to this. It's just so simple. Now, the thing that I didn't mention a moment ago is Dina Wakely's paint. Whether it's the 1-ounce squeezy bottles like I have here, or we're talking the 2-ounce tubes, all on sale starting today at 30% off, as is the brushes and the tool set and all of the gels and mediums. So the entire line of Dina Wakely paint, good grief, is 30% off.